In this video, I'm going to show you how to make hydrogen gas using easily obtainable materials, and also what you can do with it. To make the hydrogen, we're going to use aluminium or aluminum, depending on where you're from, sodium hydroxide or lye, and water, some 6mm or 1/4 inch tubing, a large soda bottle, and a heat-proof flask with a rubber stopper. The hydrogen is created in the flask and it's an exothermic reaction, so it heats up rapidly. This creates water vapor, which can carry traces of the sodium hydroxide. To remove as much of this as possible, we pass the gas through a bubbler, which is the soda bottle, filled with water. It also helps to prevent any flames passing back down the tubing and exploding the flask. So first we cut 2 lengths of pipe, sand the top of the soda bottle, drill 2 holes through the soda bottle cap, and enlarge them with a step drill until the pipes just fit through. The longer of the 2 pipes should reach the bottom of the soda bottle, and that's the one that connects to the stopper on the heatproof flask. Next, we glue the pipes in place using epoxy adhesive. The pipe connects to a glass soda straw, which is pushed through the rubber stopper. Heat the pipe to make it more flexible, and then push the pipe over the glass soda straw. To store the hydrogen, we're going to make a system that displaces the water from a lower bottle into a higher bottle. To do that, we're going to need 2 large soda bottles, some 6mm or 1/4 inch tubing, a non-return or check valve, and a tap used for aquarium airlines, and some hard plastic party straws. Firstly, cut 3 lengths off the party straw. Sand the soda bottle lid, inside and out. Drill 3 holes through the lid, and then enlarge the holes with a step drill until the straws can just fit through. Sand the bottom of the shorter straw and the middle of the 2 longer straws. Fit the straws through the lid, mix some epoxy adhesive, and glue the straws inside and outside the lid. Cut another 5cm or 2-inch section of straw, sand the base of the 2nd soda bottle, drill a hole through it, enlarge the hole with the step drill, sand the base of the straw and fit it into the hole. Using epoxy adhesive, glue the straw into place. For the 2nd soda bottle lid, do the same again with a single 5cm length of straw. Cut a length of pipe to reach all the way to the bottom of the 1st soda bottle. Using some heat to make the pipe flexible, fit the pipe to one of the 2 longer straws. Cut a length of pipe and push it onto the tap, and then push the other end onto the short straw of the 1st soda bottle. Push another length of pipe onto the other end of the tap. Cut a 40cm or 16-inch length of tubing and connect it to the 2nd long straw. The other end of the tube is connected to the non-return check valve. Cut a 20cm or 8-inch length of tube and connect it to the 1st long straw. This is the straw with a pipe connected to the other side. Now connect the other end of the tube to the base of the 2nd soda bottle. To mount the soda bottles, wrap some steel wire around the neck of each bottle to form a hook. Finally, connect the output pipe from the gas generation bubbler to the non-return check valve. Attach the soda bottles to a length of wood using screw eyes. Fill the bubbler with water until it's 3/4 full, and the bottom collection bottle until it is almost to the top. So that's the equipment ready, but before we go further forward, sodium hydroxide is extremely corrosive and can cause you serious injury, so we need to wear protective gloves, clothes, and eyewear. So with that in mind, I measured out 20 grams of sodium hydroxide, scrunched up some aluminium foil into balls, then I added 400 milliliters of distilled water into the heatproof container and slowly added the sodium hydroxide. Once that was dissolved, I added the balls of aluminium foil and replaced the rubber stopper. The reaction starts off slowly at first, with a small but steady stream of hydrogen passing through the bubbler. As production increases, the hydrogen is stored in the bottle on the left and the water displaced into the bottle above it. Once the storage bottle is full, the excess hydrogen bubbles up through the top expansion bottle and we can collect it by securing a 40 litre trash bag to the lid with an elastic band. Now we have some hydrogen, and this is the fun bit, so we're going to need a face shield and ear protectors. I've added some soapy water to this cup, and turning on the tap produces hydrogen bubbles, and I can ignite them with a barbecue lighter. Let's do it again and capture it in slow motion. So these bubbles are hydrogen rather than the hydrogen-oxygen mix that you'd get from electrolysis, and that's the reason it's burning rather than exploding. While I was burning the bubbles, the trash bag has continued to inflate. So I've tied up the bottom and attached it to some fishing line, and it's just floating there. But you're not watching this to see balloons float, so... This is an empty eggshell with a hole in the top and the bottom. I'm filling it with hydrogen and keeping some tape over the top hole to stop the hydrogen leaking out. I light the top hole, and as the hydrogen burns, it pulls oxygen in through the bottom hole, creating an explosive mixture. That was a Pringles can filled with hydrogen and a bit of flour. This is in slow motion, and if you look carefully, you can see the flour partially ignites. This is a 4-pint plastic milk carton filled with hydrogen, and it's working in the same way as the egg. The force from this was incredible, blowing out the sides and the top of the milk jug. Finally, I made a stove from a couple of Coke cans. It has three holes in the top for burners, and it's filled with fiberglass insulation. That's it for now. If you like this project, then you might like some of my others. Please subscribe and check out my website at techiediy.org. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next time.